Hello and welcome to another Deceptology video here at State Library Victoria. My name is Nicholas J. Johnson. Before we begin, I'd just like to acknowledge the traditional owners of the land where we are today and their elders, past and present. We have a fantastic video for you today. The State Library Victoria has the W.G. Alma Conjuring Collection, a massive collection of books dedicated to one subject, magic. And as a professional magician, I love getting in and discovering all of the wonderful tricks you can learn. However, I also love learning the science behind the tricks, the scientific and psychological principles that explain why you get fooled. And so today I'm going to show you a trick and I'm going to show you how you can do it yourself at home. Today's trick, the neural adapter. This device is called a neural adapter. It does no less than manipulate the inner workings of the human brain, changing the way in which you perceive reality itself. For example, take a look at your hand. Either one, it doesn't matter. It looks like a pretty normal hand, right? Well, not for long, because I am about to change the way in which you perceive your hand. Mind blowing. So, what we're going to need is this, the neural adapter, and all you need to do is to stare at this silver dot for 20 seconds, okay? So, I'm going to take it like this, I'm going to turn it, and you just have to stare at that silver dot. Now you might start to feel a little bit queasy. That's okay. Do not worry. That's perfectly normal. You might start to feel a little bit dizzy. That is also okay. That happens a lot. You may want to throw up all over your lap. That is a problem. Do not do that. Okay. Now I think we've just about reached maximum neural adaptation. So I'm going to count down from 5 to 1 and then I'd like you to look at your hand. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And whoa! Now, 95% of people would have just seen their hand seem to bulge and grow and get bigger. If you were one of those 5% of people that it didn't work on, that's okay. You can just go back and watch the video again and maybe stand a little bit further away from your screen and see if it works for you then. So why does this happen? Why is it that staring at this spinning disc makes your hand look bigger? Well, I wasn't lying when I said that this is a neural adapter. What this does is that it adapts the way in which your brain perceives information, the way it recognizes stimuli. So, for example, when you look at the spinning disc, you can see that it looks like it's getting bigger. It looks like it's getting closer to you. And so your brain registers, oh, it's getting closer. But after a couple of seconds, your brain says, oh, hang on, it's not getting bigger at all. It's not getting closer. And so it chooses to ignore that information. It sort of filters it out. Here's another example for you. Right now, you cannot feel your bum. But now that I've mentioned it, you can, right? Because what happens is we sit down on a chair, our brain goes, yep, I know what that feels like. And then your brain filters out the information. It adapts. So in this case, your brain is filtering out the information and it's telling you things that are getting bigger are actually staying the same size. The problem is that when you stop looking at this and you look at your hand, it takes a few seconds for your brain to readapt. And so your hand appears to bulge and change shape. Now you get this effect all the time. If you play a dancing game or a game like Guitar Hero, you'll often see an image flying across the screen. And again, it will look like something is moving. It will look like something is moving away from you or towards you. And your brain will choose to ignore that stimuli. When you look at the wall after you've been playing the game for a while, it will appear to move. You get the same effect if you stare at a waterfall or even a marching band, a big enough marching band that's marching by you and they just keep walking and walking and walking and your brain can't cope with the stimuli. You also get this experience when you put your backpack up on the morning. It's way too heavy. You can't handle it. It's digging into your shoulders. You feel like there's no way you can possibly handle it. And then your brain adapts. It filters out the stimuli and your bag doesn't feel heavy anymore. Until you get to school and you take it off and you feel like you're flying away. So I'm going to do it again for you, but this time, instead of turning it this way, I'm going to try and turn it in the opposite direction. You can look at your hand and then you can compare the difference between the spinning disc moving forwards and the spinning disc moving backwards. Okay? So let's give it a try. Here we go. Moving in the opposite direction. So the reason why you might feel a little bit dizzy and you might feel a little bit queasy is because the spinning disc is messing with your idea of movement. It's trying to convince you that something is moving when it's not. And because your brain uses information from your eyes to tell you where it is in space, your brain starts to get a little bit dizzy, becomes a bit disorientated. All right, I've spun that enough. I'm going to count down from 5 to 1, and then you can look at your hand again. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Look at your hand. Now, what happened? Did your hand get smaller? Did your hand get bigger? Did it stay the same size? Maybe watch the video again and try it looking at different objects. Maybe look at your face in the mirror. Maybe look at something that's moving. Maybe look at the television and see all the different ways in which this effect can affect you. I'm also going to provide you with instructions in the links below so that you can make your very own spinning disc and you can go out into the world and adapt some neurons. My name is Nicholas J. Johnson, and thanks to the State Library of Victoria, this has been Deceptology.